Harry Reid, the leader in the Senate, the cure for common charisma. A man with the oratorical skills of the OnStar operator.
We are back. So when it comes to politics, comedian Bill Maher doesn't pull any punches. You might have noticed that if you watch his HBO show. Well, recently he's been thinking about how dysfunctional politics have become in this country, and he's been dishing on both parties as he takes his message to red state America. Our Harry Smith caught up with him.
Reliably funny and reliably liberal, Bill Maher has been mounting a one-man comedic insurgency around the country.
I know. Everywhere there are smart, progressive, free-thinking people. They're just surrounded by a bunch of rednecks. I understand that. But
what's it like when you take your stuff to a red state?
Better than blue states even. But there is an extra added excitement in red states, in places where people don't often see someone like me. There is not a place I can find in America that is so red that I can't get 3,000 screaming atheists to come see me on a Sunday, you know.
Maher's sardonic smirk has held forth Friday nights on HBO for more than a decade. He says if the country has a case of the blahs, he's not surprised. Take health care, please.
Was Obamacare a mistake?
The problem with Obamacare is not, of course, too much socialism. It's still too much capitalism. The reason why it's so screwed up is because we have to have this Rube Goldberg plan that allows for pharmaceutical companies to get their cut and insurance companies to get their cut and hospitals to enrich themselves and doctors to get rich. It should be a nonprofit thing. Perhaps elections should not be a profit-making endeavor or cost $2 billion. Of course, we're American, the exceptionalism. Exceptionally stupid on this point, but we are exceptional.
Obama's soft on terror. Ask any wedding party in Afghanistan. He is so soft on terror. Like, remember that time he found bin Laden and he let him off? With a warning and a stiff fine.
And if anyone's to blame for most of what ails us, including the president's low approval ratings, it's not hard to guess who he faults.
Who are you most displeased with these days, Republicans or Democrats?
Oh, come on. Really? Seriously? Republicans, you know, I mean, in the last 20 years, that has not really been a choice. They just drove the short bus to crazy town at a certain point.
In a Bill Maher-run world, there'd be more news on the news, more Democrats in Congress, and a marijuana store in every strip mall.
Is legalization of marijuana...
Yes.
...in inevitability?
I think it is. Yeah, I keep comparing it to gay marriage. Once you see it becoming legal and the world doesn't fall down the next day or the next week or the next year, the issue kind of goes away.
From Maher's admittedly clouded perspective, the world is most definitely askew.
I understand why the 1%, the richest 1%, vote Republican. They deserve those votes. You know what? They represent the richest 1% perfectly. Anybody else who does? Just corporate America's useful idiots.
As for ennui or malaise, if it's real, it's our fault.
What's wrong with us?
Well, gosh, where to begin with there? Well, first of all, we're not very well informed. I mean, the political process, you know, people used to take civics. They say at least know how the country worked. We have become a country where science is poo-pooed. It's another one of those things that somehow has become politicized. People never used to argue that much about science. We might argue about how we take these facts and move forward in a different direction, but we don't argue about the facts themselves. That's not true anymore. Facts themselves. Come on, Harry, how much do we really know about facts?
For Meet the Press, Harry Smith.
Thank you, Harry. I want to end with this. If Bill Maher is talking about comparing Republicans and Democrats, we posed this question a little bit earlier on Facebook. Will President Obama be an asset or a liability for Democrats in November? It ties this conversation together. What do you think, Israel?
Well, I mean, I think especially this week, I think it's going to be a liability. I'm going to be curious to see how the president follows through on the Russian-Ukraine situation. Mm-hmm. We heard a lot of, frankly, platitudes. And so I'm looking for substance. The Heritage Foundation, we've made a number of recommendations, including withdrawing from the New START treaty. So that's what I'm looking for.
One Democrat and our reporters found said that Obama has become poison. Mm. So I think that's in the liability.
That's in the liability. What do you see?
I think it's a little early. The 41%, no one's going to be inviting him now. We don't know what's going to change. But the other thing that was in that poll, Republican brand is not very good at all. In fact, it's worse than the Democratic brand in term when it comes to Congress. So it's not going to be like the Republicans are going to be able to capitalize on that much. But I don't think you're going to see the president visiting as many places as he has in the past.
Yeah. Real estate wise, obviously, it will not be a positive. But the only person that can get Democratic voters excited and push an agenda that gets them some matter of enthusiasm to change turnout has to be the president.
Yeah. Or Bill Clinton.
I was about to say.
Or Bill Clinton, right. Where's Bill Clinton? All right. Thank you all very much. Final note here. March Madness is here. And this year it will include my alma mater, American University, the Eagles. They're going to the big dance for the first time since 2009 after winning the Patriot League championship. We're very proud. Go AU. That's all for today. We'll be back next week. If it's Sunday, it's Meet the Press.